it, Chuck. Thanks for inviting us to your party.
Thanks for coming, Patty. Hi, Linus.
Hi, Lucy.
Happy anniversary, Blockhead. So where's the cake and ice cream?
Oh, gee, Lucy. It's a little early for...
Come on, everybody. Let's party.
Thank you.
What's that story?
You did a great show last night. I was real proud of you. You did go over the top, over the 100% mark. Now we only can go up. We can't go down, right?
Yeah.
Right. Let's once again keep everyone in our prayers tonight that can't be here.
Guys.
Those of us that are sick, please conserve your energy and your voices. It's a real tough time of year. Let's start out by our Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever.
Okay, guys, listen. Black Lives Matter and happiness. It's really supposed to be a happy song. You can have a smile.
I'm gonna start crying.
I want big smiles on everybody and facial expression and happiness. I just want to be oozing from your pores.
Oozing, right?
Oozing. Is it coming around here?
It's
coming.
Next one.
Is it here yet?
Liz, please.
Is it here? I don't know why these things take so long. It's supposed to be like electricity. Okay, ready?
Humble thyself in the sight of the Lord.
You did a great job last night. I expect you to do the same tonight. Everybody raved about the show last night. I was over here at Mercy. Everybody loved it. I heard positive things from McQuaid. Positive. So go out there, have a good time, smile, have fun. Go over that 100% tonight.
You guys, okay? I talked to some of the college people this afternoon, and they said they wish they could be here, especially Erin Curtin, said that she wanted to wish you guys good luck, and she was really proud of us. And really cute. So,
you know,
did too.
You know what? I'll send you
Send you Becky and Sarah. They'll wish you guys luck too. They're all with us.
Okay, guys. Break a leg tonight. Have fun.
Classmen.
Get the pit.
Hey, girls.
Ladies.
Do we remember our cheer this summer?
Are we going to embarrass you getting noble?
Well, that's the way it goes.
his lack of confidence. His stupidity, his clumsiness, his inferiority, his lack of confidence. His...
Did you know that Charlie Brown has never pitched a winning baseball game, never been able to keep a kite in the air, never won a game of checkers, and never successfully punted a football? Sometimes I marvel at his consistency.
Charlie Brown's really not the most popular boy in school, but he is my big brother. He helps me tie my shoes and walk across the street, and he helps me with my homework. He's not always right, but he is my big brother.
I think Charlie Brown has nice hands.
It truly is a dog's life. Just so neglected. Charlie Brown never brings me coffee in the morning.
Now, Mike, I want you to take a good look at Charlie Brown's face. Would you please hold still a minute, Charlie Brown? I want Linus to study your face. Now, Charlie Brown has what you call a failure face, Linus. Notice how it has failure written all over it. Study it carefully, Linus. You rarely see such a good example. Notice the deep lines, the dull, vacant look in the eyes. Yes, I would say that this is one of the finest examples of a failure face that you're liable to see for a very long while.
Some mornings, I'll get up early to watch the sunrise, and I'll think how beautiful it is, and how my life lies before me. And I get a very positive feeling about things. Like this morning, for instance. The sky's so clear and the sun's so bright. How could anything go wrong on a day like this? Is among the worst times of the day for me, always having to sit here alone. Of course, the mornings aren't so pleasant either, just lying there and wondering if anyone would really miss me if I never got out of bed. And then there's the night, too, lying there and thinking of all the stupid things I've done during the day. then all those hours in between?
When I do all of those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is among the worst times of the day for me. I better see what I've got. Peanut butter.
You know, some psychiatrists say that people who eat peanut butter sandwiches are lonely.
I guess they're right.
And when you're really lonely, well, peanut butter sticks to the roof of your mouth.
Boy, the PTA sure did a great job painting these benches.
Oh, well, there's that cute little redheaded girl eating her lunch over there. I wonder what she would do if I went up and asked if I could sit next to her. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's very hard for a face to get laughed into. Oh, there's a space next to her on the bench. I could go over and sit next to her. I could do that right now. All I have to do is stand up. I'm standing up. I'm sitting down. I'm a coward. I'm so much of a coward, she wouldn't even think of looking at me. In fact, she hardly ever does look at me. You know, I can't remember her ever looking at me. Well, why shouldn't she look at me? Is there any reason why she shouldn't look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small that she can't take one moment out of the day just to... She's looking at me. She's looking at me.
No, Patty, you're thinking of the other dress. The one I wore to Lucinda's party. The one I'm talking about was the very light blue one, and it had a design embroidered around the waist. I don't remember. Something like this, and the skirt went out like this, and had puffy sleeves, and a sash like this. Oh, yes, I remember. Yes, well, that's the dress I was wearing when I met Rita, and she told me she'd see one just like it over at
Lunchtime is among the worst times of the day for me. If that little redheaded girl is looking at me with this stupid bag on my head, she must think I'm the biggest fool alive. But if she isn't looking at me, then maybe I could take it off quickly and she wouldn't notice. But then I can't tell if she's looking at me unless I take the bag off or not. So if I never take the bag off, I never have to find out whether she was looking at me or not. On the other hand, it's very hard to breathe in here.
She's not looking at me. I wonder why she never looks at me.
Oh well, one more lunch hour over. Only 2,628 to go. We just really don't appreciate the miracle that is the modern daily newspaper. You know, it's hard to put in words just why one likes a newspaper.
I like the newspaper because you don't have to dial it.
Reports. A blanket is as important to a child as a hobby is to an adult. Many a man spends his time restoring antique automobiles, or building model planes, or collecting old telephones, or even studying about the Civil War. This is called playing with the past.
Really?
Certainly, and this is good, for helps these men to cope with their everyday problems. Now, I feel it's going to be absolutely necessary for me to get my blanket back. So I'm just going to have to give it a good yay! It's amazing what you can accomplish with a little smooth talking and some fast action. For by achieving happiness himself, he can help others find it too. Does that make any sense to you?
We had spaghetti at our house 3 times this week. What would you think, Schroeder, if someday you and I got married and we were so poor that you had to sell the piano to buy me saucepans?
Saucepans?
Well, certainly.
You don't expect me to set up housekeeping without a good set of saucepans, do you?
Saucepans?
Girls have to think about these things. Boys are lucky. Boys never have to think about things like saucepans.
I can't stand it. I just can't stand it. Here's the mighty jungle egg, pounding his chest while the other animals cower in the distance. Then he throws back his head and emits a terrifying roar!
How humiliating. What's the matter, Teddy?
I don't know. I was jumping rope and everything was fine. But then suddenly, it all just seemed so futile.
I would have made a terrific trophy. Much better than running and racing. All that does is prove her point.
I'm sorry, dear mother. I admit I've been bad, and you were right to cancel my party. From now on, I shall try to be good.
I'd rather die!
countryside. He loved the peace and the quiet of the country. They were an inspiration to him.
Give me that body, you blockhead!
They don't have it nice.
Hey, Snoopy, we're home from school.
Oh.
Hi there, fella. Gosh, it's good to see ya.
Oh, Snoopy, you're so adorable.
Okay, Snoopy, back on your doghouse, and I'll be out late with your supper.
I think Snoopy's such a wonderful dog.
Me too. He's just about the best there is.
Well, isn't it remarkable how things turn out so well? Pleasant day, pretty sky, life goes on, here I lie, not bad, not bad.
Thank you. La da 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 da. A blanket and me. It's a cozy sanctuary, but it's far from necessary, 'cause I'm just as self-reliant as before. In a simple demonstration of my independent station, I will go away and leave it on the floor. Yes, I'll walk away and leave it, though I know you won't believe it. I'll just walk away and leave it on the floor.
Don't ever let me do that again.
Gotcha back again. My blanket at me. It's foolish, I know it. I'll try to outgrow it. It's my blanket
and me.
Thank you.
little more wind, a little more hope. Gotta get this stupid kite to fly. Gotta make sure it doesn't snag, doesn't droop, doesn't drag. Gotta watch out for every little oof. A little less speed, a little more tack, a little less rise, a little more slack. Gotta keep my wits about me now. Gotta make sure it doesn't get the best of me till I get the air somehow. Millions of little kids do it every day. They make a kite poof, it's in the sky. Leave it to me to have the one poor kite who likes to see a little kid cry. Little less talk, little more skill, little less luck, little more will. Gotta face this fellow wide eye. Not gonna see you chasing moles, climbing trees, digging holes, catching your string on everything passing by. Why not fly?
Wait a minute, what's it doing? It isn't on the ground. It isn't in a tree.
It's in the air.
Look at that. It's caught the breeze now. It's past the trees now. With room to spare. And oh, what a beautiful sight. And I'm not such a clumsy guy.
Parties and dances. I stand like a stick, or I cough, or I laugh, or I
Don't bring the present or I spill the ice cream, or I get so depressed that I stand in ice cream. Oh, oh! Nobody likes me, not Frida, or Shirley, or Linus, or Schroeder.
Or Lucy.
Or Lucy.
Or Snoopy.
Or Snoopy. Hey, wait a minute! Snoopy likes me!
He only pretends to like you because you feed him. That doesn't count.
Snoopy. Oh, how could there possibly be a small person as totally, totally ugly?
Wait! You're not very much of a person. And yet there is reason for hope.
There is hope?
For although you are no good at music like Schroeder, or happy like Snoopy, or lovely like me, you have got it enchant me. No one else but the singular, remarkable, unique Charlie Brown.
I mean... Lucy, I'm beginning to feel better already. You're a true friend, Lucy. A true friend.
That'll be 5 cents, please.
Discuss the sociological implications of failing pressure,
so great as to drive an otherwise moral rabbit to an exit thievery, which she consciously knew were against the law. I also hope to explore the personality of Mr. McGregor and his kick and conflicting roles as far as humanity.
If I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is no good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday, unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'll be lots of pressure if I wait till tomorrow. I should start writing now, but if I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is no good at all.
The name of the rabbit was good. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, yeah!
Down in the stands, eyes went back, and I fell like a sack full of lead. Quack! The sheriff laughed, and he left him for dead. But he was wrong.
35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Just at the arrow flew in. Clear! There was a sign for the fight. 20 minutes, damn! A minute more, and the sheriff could win. But not for long. Away they ran. Just like rabbits. Run a lot, as you can tell from the story of Peter Rabbit. Where's this report? Is about.
How do they expect us to write a book before?
Beethoven Day!
Beethoven Day!
Beethoven Day!
Beethoven Day!
Beethoven Day!
me.
Why are you telling me? I like it. That's good philosophy. Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? Why are you telling me? My new philosophy. The teacher gave a D on last week's homework. She said, Miss Sally Brown, your brains are going down. I could have told her.
Philosophy.
My new philosophy. Miss B, I'm T. Book C, a D, a D.
Someday, 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 Why spoil it for the rest?
Snoopy, where's your thrill of the chase? Where's your sense of adventure? What kind of dog are you anyway?
A sleeping dog. You take it from there.
You should be ashamed of yourself. Wasting a perfect day like this. The scent is fresh, the trail is clear. Let's get out there and chase us down a big old rabbit.
Well, I get the feeling they're determined. All right, it's a rabbit chase they want. It's a rabbit chase they're gonna get.
All right, we ought to see lots of game today.
Manager Schroeder was captured and all of the team was the same.
disaster struck at the baseball game.
Crabbiness? You see, I don't know.
Your balance needs
You may have a few moments to think it over if you want, or we can come back to the question later.
Can I come back to that one later?
Certainly. Now, the next question deals with personality traits you may have observed in me. Regarding personality, would you say that mine is A, forceful, B, pleasing, or C, objectionable? Would that be A, B, or C, Charlie Brown? Tell me that! A, B, or C, Charlie Brown! Charlie Brown!
Well, I guess I have to say forceful, isn't it?
Forceful? I see. We'll just put a check mark at the letter A, then. Now, the next question deals with my ability to get along with other people. Would you rate my ability to get along with other people as perfect or excellent?
Well, I guess that depends on what you mean by get along with other people.
You know, make friends, sparkle in a crowd, that sort of thing.
Do you have a space for abstention?
Certainly! I'll just put a check mark in. None of the above. Now, the next question deals with physical appearance. Referring to my beauty, would you say that I was stunning, mysterious, or intoxicating?
I don't know, Lucy. You look just fine to me.
Stunning. All right, Charlie Brown, let's get back to that first question. Now, on a scale of 0 to 100, using the standard of 50 and average, 75 is above average, and
I do you remember the question, Lucy?
Well,
51?
51 is your crabbiness rating for me. Thank you very much for helping with this survey, Charlie Brown. Your cooperation has been greatly appreciated.
Welcome, Lucy. Come on, Snoopy. Oh.
I'm no good, Linus. I'm
Every now and then I say the right thing. I know it's surprising, but I'm sure Lucy knows now that she can't be crabby anymore.
Where is everybody?
I told them to be here. If we don't rehearse, we can't sing at the assembly tomorrow. Charlie Brown, Linus, Lucy!
Give me that pencil, you blockhead!
No, not until you give me back my pants!
That's not that pencil, you blockhead! If you don't give me my pencil, I'll tell Patty what you said about that. What pencil?
You're late, you better rehearse! Now remember, this is a mood piece. We must paint a picture with music and words. And concentrate!
No!
Remember, adagio, con brio.
Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play.
Give me my pencil.
Where seldom is heard a discouraging word.
Not on your life.
The skies are that cloudy all day.
If you don't tell me what you don't lose,
give me that pencil, you
rat! Come on, the race.
Pencil.
No!
The deer.
I'm also scared to death of the...
Pennsylvania.
Sometimes I think I'll just pull up stakes and move out of here. See new places, meet new people. But something always binds me to the spot. That good old supper dish.
Yeah, it's supper time. Whoa, it's so damn various time of day. It's supper time.
Happiness is playing
Charlie Brown.